Okay. Just one other announcement I need to make in regards to our Bible studies. Not doing Wednesday morning any longer. We're going to be going back to Thursdays at 9:30. So we'll be starting a brand new study this Thursday, 9:30. It's Fresh Encounters. You don't want to miss it. And there will be, for the first time since March the 15th, there will be Lenny's Donuts. I found that if you feed them, they will come. So Thursday morning. Now, our Monday studies have opened back up. Wednesday will be Wednesday evening. Brad Taylor will be going back to the Thursday studies at 6:30. If you come early at 6 o'clock, we'll have a prayer meeting together. 6:30, the study starts. It's going to be a study on the Holy Spirit. We've been studying revival and prayer. You can't study revival and prayer without studying the Holy Spirit. It's called the Forgotten God. You won't want to miss this study. It's a 7, I think, 8-week study. You're going to enjoy it. 6:30 Wednesday nights. So that's our Bible studies. I want to get that also kind of cleared up there. Then also, many of you have probably been made aware of the fact that one of our young ladies has passed away. Sandy Armstrong, name was she married Wally Johns, Sandy Johns. She passed away this past week. Excuse me. And then her funeral is going to be tomorrow at 11. Excuse me. The viewing from 11 to 1 o'clock at Murphy Parks, and then the funeral will be at 1 o'clock at the funeral home. So this is Susan Fancher's niece, and been a long time in the nursing home at Waldron. Has been under failing health. So pray for the entire family, especially her husband Wally, during these days, and also their extended family. So thank you so very much for your prayers for them. We've been putting out prayers. Now today we're going to be, and that's going to be an awesome thing today. Amen. Always enjoy that. But just before that, we're going to have some testimonies and some things that. In regards to the Ladies Grace House, the Clarity Ministry, and also our prayer ministry that we enjoyed for 10 weeks on Wednesday nights. And by the way, those of you who came, I already said that about last Saturday night. I already said that. So anyway, I don't need to say that again. But anyway, we've had a wonderful time of learning about prayer and entering into prayer. So without any further notice, we have some young ladies who are going to share some testimonies today. And I don't know which one is going to be doing all the talking. But you all come on up, and thank you, gals, for your willingness to share with us what's been going on in your lives over these last several weeks in regards to how God has been working and moving. So just come on up and give us kind of the highlights of what's happening, all right? And don't you all move first, okay? All right, there we go. And speak really right, really clear right into the microphone there. Get up real close there, Jamie. Up real close. There we go. All right. Okay, thank you, Jamie.
Good morning, family.
Good morning.
My little sis Christian, she's going to say a prayer and bless us that, you know, the Holy Spirit speaks through us. God is good, you know?
Amen. Okay. Let's get it down here for Christian. All right. Come on down, Christian. Come on. There you go, sweetheart. Amen.
Dear Heavenly Father, we just want to come before you today and ask you to guide these ladies in what you want them to say and with your words. We ask you to be with all of them in your testimony, in their testimonies through you. And we just want to thank you for continuously blessing us in our lives and leading us down the right path. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Now, there might be some people here that don't understand Grace Ministries, Grace House Ministries. So, Jamie, you might just want to share just a real quickie there, okay? Just real quick.
Grace House Ministry, Greg Parks' family, and Hope's Point,
Ed Moore. Ed Moore.
Ed Moore.
Okay. That's me.
They, you know, they have a men's Grace House, and a couple years ago in 2018, they opened up a women's house, and I was one of the first, you know, pack of 15 girls, and so, you know, I have a bond with those girls still, and I was 2 weeks away from graduating, and I went back out because, you know, I'm an addict and an alcoholic, and I kind of turned away from God and put my energy into something else, you know. And anyways, so you know, God set me down for a whole year, and, you know, I read a lot of this book.
Amen.
And by God's grace, I'm back at the Grace House.
Praise the Lord.
Yes. And, you know, I have more knowledge now, more wisdom, and God's been working through my life a lot more. And actually, 2 days before Christmas in 2018, I got baptized right up here.
Amen.
Yeah, it's kind of funny because I wanted Pastor Moore to break the ice and, you know, put me in some little, a river or something. Okay. It's right. Well, we'll do that, but Joan might be mad because I'll be in the hospital for cardiac arrest. But so it was beautiful. And so what prayer night has done for me and for a lot of us girls is, I used to pray, routinely, just, roll out of bed, get on my knees, and, saying the same old prayer. Sometimes I would add stuff to it, but working with the prayer thing and learning new stuff, you got to pray from your heart. And so so my heart started hurting for my sister in Christ, Therese, because she was struggling, and I got to see that. And she's about to give you her testimony. But so I was asking God to please help her, And so on a couple weeks ago on Monday, my phone broke for 3 whole days. Mm. So, me being at the Grace House and in this community, because she's not really from this community, I was able to say, hey, let's do this, let's do that. And we went to Bible study with Miss Karen over here, and we all prayed over Therese. And and when prayers go up, blessings fall down.
Praise the Lord.
I'm going to let her tell you about what God's done for her life.
Amen. Well, that's great. You guys got this all really well planned. Come on. All right. This is better than even my own sermons. Okay.
Okay.
Well, all right. All right, here we go. I'm sorry. Please forgive me. I didn't.
Okay. So my name's Therese, and it's been a long journey. First of all, I am a child of God.
Amen.
And a mother. And after my fiance's suicide, I fell into addiction. I was living in an addict world and an addict life. And even after I decided to get clean, I was still living in that addict world. And I grew up in the church and knew who God was. But through the program of Alcoholics Anonymous, I started to get to know God. Mm-hmm. I didn't have a whole lot of faith. And through the program at the Grace House and Ed and our prayer service, I learned how to pray with faith and to have faith in God that He can do for us what we can't do for ourselves.
Amen. Amen.
And I've had so many beautiful blessings. I had a child in 2019 while I was incarcerated. Mm. And that child was given to the grandparents because the father had died of an overdose. It was a real struggle for me. Going in and out of depression, and I just kept having faith and kept praying, and everything worked out exactly like it was supposed to. And I stopped praying for my will to be done or for the way I wanted things to turn out. The more I pray for God's will to work in my life, the better it gets.
Amen.
And I had to take the grandparents to court for visitations to see my son. And I didn't pray for it to go my way. I prayed for God's will to be done.
Amen.
And
Amen.
It actually ended up way better than I ever expected.
Praise the Lord.
And yesterday I got my first visit with my 11-month-old son.
Wow. Yesterday. Bless the Lord. Amen.
I am so thankful, and I'm so blessed to be here right now. It was amazing, and I'm glad that I got to share this with everybody. How the power of prayer, it's worked throughout my life, and I just feel filled with the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
And the way that God's worked in my life, I am so thankful and so blessed.
There you go, honey. You just go ahead and preach. Go right ahead. You got the Holy Spirit. You just go ahead.
Yeah. So, thank you.
Bless you, sweetheart. That is, isn't that incredible? The power of prayer. Wow. That's why I wanted, because we just finished up, doing a study on prayer, and I know some of you weren't able to get in on the study. Some of you did pick up the book and read it and said it was a blessing to you. But that's one of the reasons why we wanted to share this today, we got some more testimonies. Okay. Let's get the napkins out. That's good. That's good. See, when God squeezes your heart, it comes out your eyes, doesn't it? So, and that's, but just yesterday, God is great. And to allow her to get back in the life of her children. Oh, it's just, I just put chills down my spine. Anyway, I'm going to shut up here. So you girls go right ahead and keep on going. The Lord's on you. You're not on me today. So you just go right on. He's just all over you guys.
I'm just going to let Kayla go next, because she's kind of new, and then we're going to say the grand finale for last of what we're all striving for, okay?
Grand finale, okay.
Okay, so my name's Michaela.
Yeah, thank you.
For a long time, I've just been lost, you know? Like, I've always known God, but I didn't really have a relationship with him. It was just kind of like a far-off relationship, not up close. I've struggled with addiction pretty much my whole life. I've never been really stable. And this time, I mean, I got sat down for quite a bit, and this time I, by the grace of God, I got to go to the Grace House, and I'm doing better than I have my entire life.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
I get to see my kids every weekend. You know, I got a new job. I have that stability. I'm not worried about where my next meal is going to come from or my next fix, for that being said. And I just want to thank the Grace House and thank God for letting me be in this program.
Praise the Lord. Amen.
Thank you.
Amen. Thank you, dear. Thank you. Wow. That is great. That is great. Karen, would you be so gracious, and when Ashley's finished with her story, could you just kind of bring it together and just let's pray for these gals for their continuance and moving forward for the Lord. So Ashley, thank you for coming today and the grand finale. I can't wait.
I didn't know that. Okay.
Yeah, Jamie kind of set you up there.
Yeah,
didn't she?
She did.
Yeah.
She did.
That's great.
I moved out of the Grace House on August 3rd, and my two kids, Brennan and Mackenzie, you guys want to come up here?
Yeah, come on up, guys. Come on up. This is cool.
This is Mackenzie, and this is Brennan. They started living with me on August 25th, and I got legal custody of them back.
Amen.
On September 9th.
Praise the Lord. How long had you been with us? Just kind of cheer people. How long you been at the Grace House?
I spent 8.5 months at the Grace House. So God wasn't ready for me to move out of the Grace House after my 6 months of completion. So I hung out there and waited for him to point me in the right direction to the right place. And I struggled with finding a place to live and getting a good job, but with time and in continual prayer and with the help of the Grace House, I was able to secure a good job and be directed towards a place to call home for myself and my two kids. I actually have a police officer for a landlord, and it's really different. Yeah, and not at the jail. We have our own place. So that's pretty
great.
Cool.
It's great.
Yeah, and they didn't, it was such a blessing. They didn't run my credit or anything.
Amen.
They just saw the changes God had bestowed upon me, and that I was living a better life, and they gave me an opportunity. And I'm very, very, very grateful for it. And we love our new home. And I absolutely love having them back in my life.
Amen.
And I owe it all to God and to the Grace House.
Yeah. Amen.
Okay. She said we have a few cats. We do. There's a few. So I got attached to the kittens of the mother. So
that's great, actually.
Yeah. Now, and now we have a fifth cat. Yeah.
Kids, I want to share something with you, that you guys were not here the night that your mother, in a prayer meeting night on Wednesday night during our study, there was a powerful moment one evening where your mother surrendered you to Jesus Christ. Whether she would ever have you back in her life ever again, and she cried out to the Lord for whatever you do. And she, that night, her will to his will. And look what has happened. Amen? Amen. God is able. God is able. Karen, would you just pray over the children and the rest of them? Rest of the group? Okay. Yeah, you're all welcome. Y'all come on up if you want. Come on down. The price is right. Come right on down. So I'm going to ask Karen if she would. Karen works with
you too.
Okay, that's good. Okay, yeah. Yeah, Joan, let's get you all on camera here, okay? Guys, hey, girls, look right up there. You're on YouTube right now. Just look right up there. I mean, you're on live stream. Y'all kind of get close in here. Get close in here. Yeah, because we want to. I don't think the camera can get you guys. Come on way over here. Come on over here. Got to get you all on the camera. You never. Hey, your future husband might be out there. Come on, get right over here. Get right over here. Amen, talk. Get right out there. Oh, okay. We are so, so blessed to have the wonderful gifts in the church of people who give their lives to help young people and young ladies and young men. And we are just so thankful. Thank you, Karen, for your dedication to these kids. And I call them kids. They're not kids. They're young ladies. And thank you so very much for giving of your life to them. So Karen's going to lead us in prayer, and you join with her as we all pray together.
Heavenly Father, I just come before you now with such a humble heart at who you are and how much you love each one of us. God, I thank you for what you have brought with each one of these women, their past and their lives now and their future. God, I thank you for the open doors that you have provided and the closed doors that you have provided.
Amen.
God, I thank you for your hand on each one of their lives. And what a joy it is to see you work in their lives and to see them change and see their hearts change. And oh my goodness, just to listen to their prayers and what they are asking you for and then rejoicing because they see you working in their lives. God, I thank you for each one of them. I pray that your hand of protection would be on each one of their lives. God, send your angels to them to lead them step by step, to guard each step they take. God, give them wisdom, give them guidance, and give them discipline to live Amen. In obedience to you. God, just protect them. Send people their way that will lead them through each struggle that they go through. And God, I just pray that you would keep them close.
Yes.
Keep
Amen.
Them close. Amen. Draw them to you.
Amen.
And help
Amen.
Them to know that you are supreme in their life.
Praise the Lord.
In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Amen. Now, we've also, thank you very much, Karen. Just real quick, gals. Teresa, was the Clarity Ministry a help to you? So we've been asking you to help in your gifts and in on the back table we have here and put your change in to help out. There you go, buddy. Okay. All right. Okay. Bless your heart. So when you give to Clarity, the Pregnancy Care Center, you also are helping young ladies in our own church. So it's wonderful people out there, but it's really, really special when one of your very own can be helped. Amen. Really, really special. And so it helped. And so gals, thank you. Thank you very much. If I had the money to take you all, I'd take you all for lunch, but I'm on a kind of a fixed income right now. So blessings. We'll do that. We'll do that one day. We'll all go out and just have a nice celebration. Okay. Maybe White Castles or something like that. I'm a big spender. All right. Blessings to you guys. You guys can be seated. Wonderful. Wonderful. Okay. Now you guys get to follow that.
No,
you're back on now.
Okay. As I would like to say that when I was pregnant and I had no one to turn to, Clarity absolutely helped me for what they did for me, helped me for over 2 years for my daughter. She's 2.5 now, and she still uses the car seat today that they gave me. That started from when she was a newborn all the way up until she's almost 2.5 now, and she still uses it. So what you do to help Clarity really goes a long way and helps ease a mother's mind.
Amen. Thank you, dear. Thank you. Wow. So, so important. Clarity, as you know, is out on State Road 44, and we're not the only church. There are a number of churches in Shelby County. We joined together to help young ladies with their little ones. And so, by the way, I just want to set your mind at ease today. I may not get to my sermon, And so I know that's going to really, really disappoint about 99% of the church. There'll be 1% that won't be disappointed. But most of you are going to be very disappointed that I didn't preach a sermon today. That's my wife. Anyway. Oh, you already heard it. You've heard it all, haven't you? So anyway. But God has a word for us today. It doesn't always have to come through a certain donkey, you know, his mouth. You know, it can come through any mouth. So we've heard from the Lord, and we're not finished up because we're going to have a baptismal service here in just a few moments. So I've asked Christy and Danny to come and share testimony of today of their celebration together of their soon to be joined baptismal together. So you guys come right on up here, and you get the joy of doing this a second time. So they shared this in their first service. And so they're going to share again in this service here just before our baptismal time. I'm going to just use one passage of scripture. It's going to be Isaiah 57, verse 15. I'm going to close with that. And I have a story. It's going to take 5 minutes, and then we'll go right into our baptism. And, oh, I'm sorry. And, buddy, I need for you to sing while we're getting ready for baptism, okay? Is that okay? Good. We're good. We're good. Okay. Whichever one wants to be first. Just stay close to the mic, okay? Are you ready? Okay, ready.
Is this thing on? I don't think it's on.
It's not on? Okay.
I can speak louder, I guess.
No, I think you're on. Is it on, guys?
Yeah,
it's on. Oh, it's on. They're good. You're good.
Some of you may or may not know. I'm Dan. This is my wife, Chrissy. And I have family here today. I want to thank you guys for showing up and supporting us. So I guess this is my story, how basically I came to the Lord. And earlier today, Ed said something. I had something planned to say, but you know, Ed said something that kind of changed a little bit. But he said that every one of us here that's saved, somebody has prayed for that. Yeah. You know, and it touched my heart, and I didn't realize until he said that. My father passed away about 4 years ago with cancer, and one of the last kind of heart-to-hearts we had was, you know, we hugged one another, and he told me, don't worry about me. I know where I'm going, but I'm worried about you. So with Pastor Ed saying that, you know, that kind of touched me. I didn't realize it. So, with that said, one of the times that the ambulance came to get my father because he was having a hard time breathing, you know, I felt lost. You know, didn't really know what to do. So, I was in the living room and waiting. We were waiting on the ambulance, and I just kind of put my head back and said a little prayer, you know, and I asked God to show me, you know, give me a sign, show me, you know, if there's a God up there, show me. So at that instant, I felt a light come and go through my body, and with that, I felt a warm, soothing, I guess, feeling, and it felt like it lifted me up off the ground. So, at that moment, there was no doubt in my mind that
God existed. Yes.
So, that's one of the first things, you know, one of the first signs to me. So, me and Chrissy, we've been going to this church for, you know, almost a year now. So, Danny Lee.
Mm-hmm.
A few weeks ago, he shared his testimony, and he had some bad news about, you know, his cancer and his battle. So when he spoke, that really was personal to me, you know, it touched my heart. So the moment that he was speaking, I was, you know, sitting over there, and the Holy Spirit entered my heart.
Amen.
And he told me, you're not leaving this church today without getting saved.
Amen.
So, you know, amen. I am very, very thankful that, you know, things happen things happen. You don't really understand. You know, you can't get your head around it, but things happen for a reason.
Yes.
God works in different ways that touch different people. So I'm just glad that he found a way to get to me.
Amen. Amen.
So that's about all I get to
praise
say.
The Lord. You guys stay right here. Just stay right here. Stay right here. Christine, before you come, Danny Lee, as you know, is my brother-in-law, and Danny shared his story here a couple of weeks ago when Danny came to Christ. I didn't know if any of Danny's family would be here this morning. I know Danny right now is in the hospital. He was taken to the emergency room last night. Is any of Danny's family here by chance? Okay. Is Brad? Are you back here, Brad? Brad, would you come on up? I'd like for you to pray on Danny's behalf. You and Rebecca just come up together. And I'd like to ask you to pray over Danny and Christy. Would you do that? And because I was going to ask Danny to do that today, to pray over Danny and Christy, because they've been coming to Mom and Dad's Bible study on Monday nights. They just started up a couple weeks ago. So it's been really exciting to see what the Lord's been doing. So we'll have Brad pray for you guys right before our baptism. Christy, the mic's yours. Okay. Here, I'll get her down here just a little bit there.
Okay. I'm not as good as my husband going off. I would never be able to spit it all out. First of all, I want to thank my family that came to share this wonderful moment with us today. We've got my mom, Brenda, my Aunt Becky and Uncle Todd, my Aunt Lisa and Uncle Terry, my cousins Grace and Austin and Kelly and Tim, my best friend Asher Balti, my dearest friend Stephanie. I just thank you guys so much for sharing this moment with us today. But my testimony is when I was 12 years old, I was baptized. Looking back, I was just a baby. I was so naive for the Lord. My sister lives in Florida and just happened to be home for that weekend. On Sunday night, I decided that I was going to spend the night at my mom and dad's house. My sister was staying there, so for the first time in our adulthood, it was just my mom, my dad, my sister, and I. No kids, no husband. Just us. At 3 in the morning, my mom woke my sister and I up saying my dad was not doing well. We called the hospital nurse to check in on him, and she told us that someone would be back to check on him later that afternoon. The nurse came and said that his organs were shutting down and that he may only have a week or so left. When she went back to check on him the second time, she was checking his blood pressure and only could find the top number. There was no bottom. She told us that we may only have hours left with him. He was awake with us the entire day. We called the family in so they could tell him their goodbyes. While everyone was there that evening, my mom asked if we could all gather around him and pray. My dad was sitting holding my mom's hand and my sister's hand. Everyone made a circle around him and started to pray out loud. One by one, each person prayed. When it was my turn, I was just thanking Jesus for my daddy he gave me. My sister was the last to pray. She started crying out to the Lord, begging Jesus to show his presence. And he definitely did. When she finished praying, in Jesus' name I pray, amen, my daddy took his last breath.
Wow.
Right there, surrounded by everyone who loved him in the middle of a prayer circle, Jesus took my daddy home. We knew in that very moment that we just received our miracle. After that, there was no turning back and no denying him. I wanted nothing more than to live my life for just him. We started coming to church regularly and completely changed our lives.
Amen.
I am so on fire for the Lord. So today I am rededicating my life to the Lord. I am ready to wash these sins away and live every day for him.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. Amen. You guys stay right here. This is Danny's son-in-law, Brad. He's going to lead us in prayer. This is Rebecca, his youngest daughter. So you guys just come together. Let's pray together. Oh, no, Brad, we need to get over so we can get you on camera. Get over here. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. There may be somebody out there on live stream that says, Brad Taylor, he's in church praying. So we love Brad. Thank you, Brad. Thank you, Rebecca. Thank you.
Lord God, we thank you. We thank you that you have planned out our lives before we could even imagine it.
That's so true. Amen.
We thank you, Lord, that your goodness pours through even the worst of the things that we may be experiencing. Father, we thank you for the love that you pour out on on all of us. We thank you for the faithfulness when we're so hard-headed and sinful. Father, we give thanks for the salvation of Danny and Christy. And we thank you, Lord, for their public confession here today and for offering themselves in baptism. And Lord, we are so grateful for how you have worked things out. Father, we know that you love us and that interceding on our behalf is your Son and the Holy Spirit. And we give thanks to the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit that you may be glorified today. Amen.
Amen. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound. Yes, take a seat. A wretch like me, I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. One verse of scripture to honor the Lord with, Isaiah 57, verse 15. For thus saith the high and lofty one, I can't get my mind around this, that inhabits, that means that's where he lives, that's God's address, inhabits eternity. Can't fathom what eternity is. We just heard weeks ago that scientists for many, many decades now have believed that there were just over 200 billion galaxies in our universe, but they've retracted. Now they say there's an excess of 300 billion galaxies. What are they going to tell us 5 years from now? They just keep finding more and more galaxies out in the universe, and God lives outside the universe. How big is God? And the Bible tells us that in the Psalms that God bows his head to behold the heavens that he has created. God has to humble himself just to look down upon his awesome creation. And yet he's omniscient. He's everywhere present at the same time. I don't understand eternity. I'll never really get my mind around that. And whose name is holy. Holy simply means he's other than us. Yeah, he certainly is. He's separate than us. And then it says, and I dwell. This is where God dwells. Here's my home. My home is in the high and holy place, wherever that is. But he said, I have another home. I have another home. I have another home that is a very favorite place for me to live. I also live with him or her that is of a contrite and humble spirit. God loves to live in a heart that is open and broken before him. Contrite simply means a person who feels deeply their sin, deeply their guilt, deeply their shame, but also rejoices in that those burdens are fully lifted at Calvary. Through the blood of Jesus, we're washed clean, even as Christy said just a moment ago. A contrite heart is a heart that realizes we are of all people most miserable without Christ. We are lost without him. And we are willing not to swallow our pride, but we're willing to kill our pride at whatever cost, whatever it takes to get before God in a humble way to acknowledge his greatness and our insignificance. God loves to see a heart that's willing to admit they need Jesus Christ. They not only need Jesus Christ in a profession of faith, but they need Jesus Christ to get up out of bed in the morning and for him to be in their life in every decision they make throughout the day, and to acknowledge his presence and acknowledge that Christ and Christ alone is their only hope, and to revive the spirit of the humble and to receive the heart of the contrite one. Do you have a contrite heart? You have a humble heart? You acknowledge his rightful place in your life? The reason why we don't pray over our marriage is because we don't need God in our marriage. The reason why you don't pray over our finances, well, God, I don't need you in my finance. I don't want you messing with my money. We don't pray to God for our children because, well, God, I'm doing okay with my kids. I don't need you messing with my kids. So we don't invite God into every area of our life. We're proud. And God resists the proud, the Bible tells us, and gives ample grace to who? Somebody tell me. He gives grace to the humble. Resists the proud. He stiff arms. And you see in the football field, men who stiff arm their opponent when they're running. They stiff arm. That's what God does. He stiff arms you. You can pray, but I'm going to stiff arm you because you've got a proud, arrogant heart. You think you can live life without me. You don't need the church. You don't need fellowship. You don't need prayer. You don't need me, so I'm going to just stiff arm you. It's an awful, awful condition to live in, being stiff-armed by God. And I've been stiff-armed by God many, many times in my life. My wife and I both could testify to that, times that we allowed pride to rule in our hearts. And we paid a great price for it. But perhaps today we bow together in prayer. And I'm going to ask Danny and Christy if you guys would slip to the rooms here. And Brother Buddy's going to come and sing a song here in just a moment as we prepare for baptism. There may be someone today who would say in their heart of hearts, I could never do what these young ladies did who stood up here publicly to testify of Jesus Christ. I could never do what Danny and Christy did. I just couldn't do that. It's amazing what we can do if we're desperate. If you're desperate for God, if you're desperate for God, there's nothing that would stand in your way. If this building was on fire and your grandchild was in the Sunday school wing, you would desperately go and rescue that child. If someone right now fell out into the aisle with a heart attack and you were sitting next, you would do whatever it took to get someone here to save that life. The reason why you say today, I could never do that, because your heart is not humble. And your heart is not contrite, and you're not desperate enough for God. Today, you have witnessed young ladies, Danny's testimony, of people who are desperate for God. And God loves hearts that are desperate for Him. So I pray this morning, perhaps there's someone here, you're not a Christian, you've never been saved, or you've never been baptized, you've never publicly given your story of your journey of coming back to Christ. We invite you to do so. Even while Buddy sings this song, a beautiful song, How Deep the Father's Love for Us. Why don't you just bow your head and say, God, I repent. I repent today. I am so, so sorry for running so far away from you. I am so far away. I don't even know if I can even get back. But I got good news. You can be a long way off, but the cross is just a prayer away. Grace is just a whisper away. You just need to say, God, I'm wrong. I'm sorry. Will you forgive me? And He will. Amen? You may feel like you're just so, so far. I can never get back. He'll bring you back in just a whisper. Cry out to Him even now while we wait. Father, bring, I pray, the spirit of repentance on us all. Father, create in me a clean heart. Create a contrite spirit within my heart. I want to stay humble. I want to stay broken. God, I want to stay open and honest with you and even this congregation. And especially those who I love. It will be an open book, known and read of all men. We have nothing to hide, nothing to conceal. You tell us if anyone conceals his sin, he'll never prosper in life. Father, give us a sense of desperation, we pray, to cry out to you. And then to love you for that deep, deep love that you demonstrated for us at Calvary when you died in the place of sinners like me and like these. In Jesus' name we pray, and all God's people can say, and amen. Thank you.
deep the Father's love for us, how vast beyond all measure, that he should give his only Son to make a wretch his treasure. How great the pain of searing loss, the Father turns his face away, as wounds which mar the chosen one bring many sons to glory. Behold the man upon the cross, my sin upon his shoulders. Ashamed I hear my mocking voice call out among the scoffers. It was my sin that held him there until it was accomplished. His dying breath has brought me life. I know that it is finished. I will not boast in anything, no gifts, no power, no wisdom, but I will boast in Jesus Christ, his death and resurrection. Why should I gain from his reward? I cannot give an answer, but this I know with all my heart. His wounds have paid my ransom. Why should I gain from his reward? I cannot give an answer, but this I know with all my heart. His wounds have paid my ransom.